Metcomm is a technology company that provides services, technology services to many schools, many of the archdiocese schools. We were lucky enough to install the first four new boards, new Promethean boards for you. And we are here now to give you some orientation, also the first boards. So we'll keep together to ease into it. It's really fun. It's an amazing board and it's really fun. Anybody today is working with Android and tablets. It's really at the end of the day, the same thing. So Maya is a lawyer, but she's also an intern with Metcomm for the second year. She did technical drawing, other things, and lately she started to realize that she's better than us. On the fun side, actually, on the education side of the committee, so she started to do orientation. So no waste of time, we let her take over. And we are around Angel, some of you already met, one of the Metcomm permanent techs. My son actually helped to install those, he's doing also internet in summer. And Chris is a part-time tech helper with Metcomm. Actually, he was involved also in the installation here and the installations around the city in many, many, many other schools here. So, thank you. Have fun.
Hello. To start off, has anyone ever worked with a Promethean board or active animal or any type of
We all had fun, but
it was
I don't know.
So there are two general categories of what you can do, and that is you can present things and you can actually interact with students through the board. The basic smart board functions can be done with your hand, with a pen. There's also an eraser. And to access the basic whiteboard on which you can draw and write and for images, you can use either this icon or you can press here and then the blue. They look exactly the same. Once you enter the whiteboard, it's going to look like this. You have your menu, your settings, and options on this side, and this stays across the board no matter what you do. If you access the browser, PowerPoint, YouTube, any other apps you might have. Drawing is simple, you just use your finger or the pen, and to erase, you either use the eraser, or this button down here. You can't erase with the pen, which is why it's handy to have an eraser. Other things you can do include you can change the layout. You can have a blank board. You can have a grid, lines. The mouse button is mainly to move around the board. You can position the lines how you want them. You have color settings here. You have basic primary colors, black, green, and you can access more colors through this button. This, once you've drawn on your board, whatever you'd like, this here, the little square with the eraser, you hit it, just wipes the whole board. And the ruler and the protractor down here actually enable you to have the protractor on the screen. If you have this on the screen, in order to remove it, you would hit the mouse, hit it. Once you've drawn again, whatever you like, you can hit this button and save it into the internal storage board. You can hit photos.
say you're writing and you need like another page or more space. Oh, and you just move slides up with your hand.
Yes.
Yeah, and then if you need to see it.
And you're just scrolling or long.
Question about when you say that, okay, to recover it.
You hit
get it back.
This button, the gallery button. And then you can see all of your photos.
Yeah. Okay. So,
where's that demo when you see it? Oh, okay.
Okay, good. So that's, so like if I'm saving something on your computer, then it just will come out as a separate screen.
Yep.
It's actually on your Google Drive. Or
on my Google, okay.
It just gets so whoever
you log in. When you log in to your Google Drive, anything that you do, either on the phone or your account on the she's logging right now on her Google Drive. To the boat. The boat is a computer by itself.
Okay, so in order to use this first, you have to be in your own Google Drive.
No, she doesn't have any of the code.
No,
she's just logged in with her phone to the Google
Drive. Right, she's working the board, right?
Right, so everything that she's saving now is actually on her drive on Google Drive.
In order to do that again, you go to the whiteboard through here and the blue button. And then you hit save the second one down. And then it saves it. This is just the whole button to help you with easier access around here. The next thing you can do is that you can hit the orange button in order to take a screenshot. And then you can simply do all the same things on top of the screenshot. This is useful if, for example, you want to import a word puzzle from the internet and then have students come up and circle words, things like that. You can also save it the exact same way. You can clear it with the same button. And if you want to use the board but remove this, you can hit the mouse and either scroll down the same way as before, or you can hit this and hit the trash can and it uses the force.
I didn't have a trash can on mine. I accidentally hit that button and I forgot why.
Sometimes it appears as an X or a different symbol, or sometimes some voices have the option to double click.
You can also zoom in.
Yeah.
Press the little arrow cursor.
Yeah.
And zoom in.
Okay.
It's like the phone. Pinch.
Intranet app, which is Google. that's, we've installed on this the gallery where all your screenshots and photos save, and the camera. We have utility apps which we've downloaded PowerPoint on this, and the whiteboard that we accessed earlier, and settings apps where you can toggle internet access, photos, and other apps. The next thing you can do is simply access the browser and not do it anywhere else. So essentially, if you don't have a computer connected to it at the moment, as long as it's connected to the school Wi-Fi, you can still do anything on your computer. If the school Wi-Fi does not block you, you can access that. You can access any other educational site or whatever you might need to show students. The next feature that this allows is class flow. What ActiveCast does is it allows you to, let's say I have this here through your computer. It's a Google extension, so if you look it up, you'll be able to, and you are logged into your Gmail account, you will be able to add this to your Gmail account and then project whatever is on your device onto the screen. There are two ways to do this. You can either scan a QR code, which is more of a hassle with a computer and holding it up and everything, or you can enter the connection ID, which is what I'm going to do now. I already have, and once you connect to a device, you will have it saved onto your thing. It will open up on this screen, and once you hit enter connection ID, the connection ID pop-up will show, and you enter it.
That's just a demo. I'm showing you, I'm connecting to my laptop, two devices at one time. So I can show you whatever's on my screen at the same time while she's on her iPad. This is a useful feature. If you have multiple devices, say you want to show something from your tablet or your phone, you can have your laptop also showing at the same time, simultaneously.
Now let me ask you a question. Once you're finished with this, connected, or do I disallow connection?
You can essentially leave it connected. However, in order to disconnect, you simply reverse the steps that you're used to. In my case, I would swipe up on my device and hit this on the connect, and then it should disconnect.
You can also swipe up. You can swipe up from the screen. Just swipe up. No, actual screen. You can swipe it like you can.
Yeah.
So you just get rid of it.
And then it disconnects. That's mostly what that does. You can also, if you, instead of swiping up, disconnect manually, you can save your device. gone over quite a few things, and it's important to note that instead of going back and reopening the apps each time, you can scroll up from here and then hit the square, and you can see everything you've opened, just like on an Android operating system. And you can swipe to close things, or you can simply hit. You can also move this around, because you can hit the line with the X to close everything at once. For the whiteboard, can you have multiple workings up at the same time? So you can have multiple like pages, for instance, or is it just one document?
Like, when you say multiple, you have like different, like a PDF, and then you have like,
no, so word. Say I want to write on the whiteboard with blue icons, and say I have it for social studies.
Now
I
want to
do something for science.
Can
I have another document of the same thing at the same time, or do I have to exit out of this one before I start
reading? You would have to save it and then move
it. Save
the
it
next
and then.
Yes. You see that what the last thing she just showed?
Yeah.
It's like a little square, and you press that and you open up the other one and just switch between both.
Okay, so now one of the biggest features, most fun and most interactive students that this board has made so is Classflow. Classflow essentially is a site that once you create a teacher's account, once you create an account, you can connect to students. This does not save my login right now, but you can have it save your login. You can also move the keyboard around, so if you are getting it higher or lower, that's also what you can do. Once I log in, the home screen looks like this. In order to create a class, once you, in order to create a class for students to join, you would hit from this menu, classes. I've already created a class for today, and it is called training, but I'm going to show you how to create a new class. Anyways, this one. You'd hit the new button, and you'd hit, if you use Google Classrooms, you can also bring in a class from there already. But in our case, I'm going to hit add a class. So, you would title your class whatever you want. You would select the subject if you like, so say design and technology, and you could select the grade level of education. Now, they give you two options for class. And these depend on the grade you are teaching and how much you plan to use the site. Student-generated classes enable the most features, as you can see here, because they require students to create an account in order to be able to join them. So students would create a basic account with their school email or password, and then you would give them your class code, and they would join in the class, and they would be kept there, and they would be able to see assignments and things you made in slideshows. However, the teacher-generated class is better for younger kids who can't necessarily make their own accounts yet. And what it does is it allows you almost everything, but students do not need to create their own accounts. So we're going to try it as I show you some more resources and things we can do. If I hit open class, and you enter this whole URL into your computer, you can join this class.
Mm-hmm.
you log into Google, you actually want to already put this URL in your bookmark. So any other computer you will open it tomorrow, you will have it. You don't have to remember any of this.
This looks like a pretty standard whiteboard that